Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. Wishing you all a very happy new year. And I would like to take a few seconds to thank you all for helping me gain subscribers. We are now 2.3k strong and the channel has over 90,000 views in total. So thank you all for the never-ending support. Let's begin with today's videos. This video is going to cover so many parts of the exams. We are going to talk about the important books or high yield resources for different exams such as USMLE, PLEB, AMC and FMG or NEXT. Also, there are some people who are asking me about the important books for 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th and 5th and 6th year of MBBS. So I have enlisted important book for all the subjects, like review books for different subjects. Let's begin with the exams first. The first exam is about USA, USMLE, United States, Medical Licensing Exam. There are about 10 resources that you can use. The first one is BRS Physiology. Now this is like the gold standard book for physiology. You can have BRS Pathology also, which is also fine. Second one is for pathology. The best one is Pathoma, also known as Fundamentals of Pathology by Dr. Hussain. Third one is DIT videos. What you can do is you can take one theory book plus one lecture or a couple of lectures or videos plus one MCQ review book. So let's say you have started with BRS Physiology, you can use DIT videos for physiology and then you can go for let's say UWorld questions. Fourth book here is, or fourth important material here is Kaplan Notes. Now if you are someone who has very strong basics and you would like to just revise through your basics, go for Kaplan Notes. Like they are short and comprehensive. Fifth one here is for the biochem and pharma, the best book is Lipin Coat. Now it is a little detailed, like in pharma the mechanism of action and everything is explained very properly in Lipin Coat. So if you have enough time, go for Lipin Coat. Sixth one is Step Up to Medicine. Now the first five were for step one of USMLE and these are going to be for the step two or combinative. So sixth one is for internal medicine, which is Step Up to Medicine. You can also use Harrison's book, but it's over detailed and you won't get time to revise that book. So just go for step up to medicine. Seventh one is Masters the Board. Now this is like the important one for step two. If your basics are like clear, you can go and revise through Master the Boards. Eighth is UWorld. Now UWorld, first aid and NBMEs, these last three resources are common for first step and second step both. What you're going to do is you're going to clear your basics from theoretical books or the review books, then you're going to watch videos along with the theory. After you're done with your main material, you're going to start practicing MCQs. The first one here is UWorld. That is USMLE World Questions. You'll start to practice the UWorld online or offline, but online are more preferable. I have told about USMLE and the procedure and about the fees and the how much the material cost. So you can go and check that video. I'll link in the description box below. UWorld, you should start practicing 6 to 10 weeks before the main exam. Ninth one is First Aid. Now First Aid, some people consider is at the god of USMLE, like you just need to go through FA to go through this exam. But this is true only if you know all the basics, if you are well known to the clinicals. So First Aid is like your revision book for after you're done with all the steps, consider going through FA. This is very short book, about 1000 to 1200 pages. So this is like all the subjects in one book. 10th is NBMEs. NBMEs are the exam that you can, they are like the practice exams that you can take before your USMLE examination to understand how well you are going to perform on your exam. You can estimate your score. So you can take about 2 to 3 NBMEs. One NBME costs about $50, so you can take 2 or 3 of them before your main exam, like maybe 2 weeks before or 3 weeks before and then let's say 4 days before your exam. It totally depends upon you how you're going to take NBMEs and the UWorld. On to the second exam, PLEB examination, which is for United Kingdom. There are two parts of this exam again, one and two. So we have the first resource here is 1700 by Dr. Khalid, the god of this exam, like the best resource that you can use. You can use these 1700 subject-wise. topic wise, with answers, with explanation, according to your preferences. Second one is subject wise unity notes. Now these are just MCQs. Let's say you have studied well through your 6 years or 4 years of your MBBS. You can go and directly start with MCQs. But if you're not feeling confident enough, you should consider going through subjective wise unity notes. Third resource here is GMC sample paper. Now one point I forgot to mention in the USMLE is, I'll link down some sample papers for USMLE. Like before you start to prepare for the USMLE, you can just understand like where do you stand. So I'll put the links for sample paper for each exam in the description box below. You can also try GMC sample paper, which is available on their website. Fourth resource here is Oxford Handbook of Clinical Medicine. Now first three are for step 1 or for PLEV 1 exam, and last two are for part 2. Oxford Handbook of Clinical Medicine and Oxford Handbook of Clinical Specialties. For clinical knowledge, you can use Oxford Handbook. That is enough, I think. If your basics are like fine and you're going to give PLEV, just go through these books. If not, I'll tell you about the review book for each and every subject individually. The third exam here is AMC, which is Australian Medical Council exam. There are about 5 books that you can consider. First one is AMC Handbook. Second one is Canada Quebec. Now this is very, very important. I'll put the link below. You can practice for USMLE, PLEB, AMC, all the examination on this website. There is one website which is like www.canadaquebec.com. Go through that question bank. Third is McLeod's Clinical. Very, very important for clinical part of this examination. Fourth review book is Oxford American Handbook. Fifth one is John Murtka General Practice Reference. Now I'll put star on the books that are like the most important ones or that everyone uses. For USMLE, these three are the important ones. Also the Pathoma. Rest depends upon you. For PLEB, definitely 1700. And these two books, Oxford Handbook. For AMC one, John Murtka General Practice Reference. Very, very important. If you don't have enough time and you only have one book to score through, go for John Murtka. And along with that, go for MCQs, Canada Quebec. So this is it for the examinations individually, USMLE, PLEB and AMC. Now, I can give you a whole list of other review books, but I think these are the high yield ones. Next, on to the next part of the video, FMG Next or MBBS. Now, this contains two sites. First is for the people who were asking about individual subjects, like, hey, which book to prefer for pathology, which book to prefer for surgery. Or for people who are going to give FMG examination on next exam, which is for getting internship or for getting a seat in PG in India. So for them or for the MBBS review books, we have about 19 subjects and I'm going to go through each of them. First one is for anatomy. Now I have given 2 or 3 choices in every subject. So you do not need to go through all of them. Just choose one book and breathe in through that book. First one is anatomy, Gray's Anatomy. Second option is Netter's Illustration. Third option is B.D. Chaurasia, very well known amongst people who do MBBS in abroad. Fourth one, Langman's Medical Embryology. Now the most important one according to me is the Gray's Anatomy. And you can use Netter's Illustration alongside. B.D. Chaurasia is fine, most of the people go through this book, but it's a little difficult to understand, I must say. So go through Gray's Anatomy and Netter's Illustration. Second subject is Neuroanatomy. For Neuroanatomy, Handelman's and Nolte's Atlas. Third subject is Histology. D4A's Atlas of Histology is the best one. Now I have given the names of the books according to what professors prefer in India. Like these are the books that are preferred in India. Fourth subject is Physiology. For Physiology, you can go through Guyton and Hall, but it is an entailed book, like you have tons of information. And if you don't have time, just go for the other review books. Second option is Genong's. Third is Mathematical Modeling by Springer. All of them are equally good. Depends upon you how well you are going to go with one book. Fifth subject is Biochemistry. Now the best one is Kaplan's video lectures. Another option is Herper's. And last option is Lippincott. I generally prefer Lippincott for biochem and pharma. Sixth subject here is pathology. The best book is definitely Robbins. Another option is Pathoma, Aka Fundamentals of Pathology. See, Robbins is what people prefers in India, but Pathoma is what is like the god for USMLE. Pathoma, also known as Fundamentals of Pathology, more clinical based book. Or you can also consider Devesh Mishra, book by Devesh Mishra. Seventh subject is Pharmacology. The best book is by K.D. Tripathi or Godman and Gilman's Basis of Therapeutics or Lippincott. I prefer Lippincott. You can go through any of these books. For microbiome, Panikkar or Sastry. Like most of the people often get confused between two. You can prefer any book. Just don't put more effort on choosing the book. You can choose any of them. Just be sure that you're going to go through that book from first page to last page and you're going to understand all the facts in that book. Ninth is immunology. For immunology, you can use QB or Levinson's. 10th is Forensic Medicine. Reddy is the best book for Forensic Medicine. 11th is PSM or Social Medicine, Preventive and Social Medicine. The best book that we use in India is by Park or by Vivek Jain. Vivek Jain is like for PG review book. Let's say if you're going to sit in next examination, you can consider Vivek Jain book. And for Epidemiology by Leon Gordis. 12th subject is ENT. Book by Dhingra. Dhingra textbook is the best. 13th, Ophthalmology, book by Parsons, or Search PG review book by Utsav. You can go through any of them. For like the book by Utsav is more for PG and Parsons is more for your general MBBS. 14th is for internal medicine. Now you can go through Davidson's or Harrison's. There is more information in Harrison's, but Davidson is good for like short and comprehensive information. Or you can go through Kundu. Kundu is like very famous in India and you can go through the clinical part of this. Or the third option is Matthews. Choose any. Again, keep your resources or keep your study material short and comprehensive. Like just focus on one book. 15th subject is surgery. There are three options. Manipal, S. Das and Bailey and Love. Now Bailey and Love is more... There's tons of information in the book. You are not going to revise it again and again, so choose wisely. I have read Surgery by S. Das, which is like fine. 16th subject is Ortho. Only one book is, I think, the best one, which is by Dr. Maheshwari. 17th is Ops in Gyna. You can have two options. You have two options here. Book by D.C. Datta or book by Dr. Sakshi Arora. Now, this is more theoretical book and... Book by Sakshi Arora, I would say go for the MCQ book. 18th is for pediatrics. OP Ghai, everyone knows about this book. Or you can consider, if you're not comfortable with this book, you can consider Meherban Singh, book by Meherban Singh or Nelson's. OP Ghai is preferred in India. Nelson's is preferred by Ukraine or Russia, like countries like Ukraine and Russia. Last subject is psychiatry. You can go through Neeraj Ahuja. Now there are some subjects or topics that are not covered in this one. For let's say skin, but the other subjects like the topics like skin and other, you can cover it under surgery or internal medicine. So this is the list of the books that you will need through your MBBS or your FMG or next examination. Now for FMG, most people go for coaching. So if you're going for a certain coaching, please go through these review books if you have time. If you don't have time, just go for their coaching notes. So this is it for this video. I haven't been uploading from past about 1 month, but I'll continue to upload from this video. So stay tuned to the channel and thank you so much for watching, sharing and subscribing.